Donald Trump promised the world untold revelations about the biggest question of our time, a validation of conspiracy theories and devastating, eradefining whack at the establishment. What we got was a high-class call girl named Kitty, some goddamned commies and the shattering exclusive that at least one Kennedy was boinking Marilyn Monroe. Revelations there were not, unless you count the head-scratching possibilities of why a senior reporter at the Cambridge Evening News was warned about big news from America 25 minutes before the shooting. Quite what the relevance would have been to East Anglia we may never know, as pretty much everyone involved in the assassination of U.S. President John F. Kennedy shuffled off this mortal coil some time since. Hence why the White House wants it was able to release 2,800 previously secret and mostly illegible documents on the killing, having promised his wingnut army that if they gave him incredible power he'd distract them from noticing what he was doing with it. There are still 300 or so papers being withheld over security concerns, because the CIA would still rather you didn't know precisely how spying works or who is still alive that did the spying, and even if any of them finally answer all our questions OMG LBJ killed JFK they'd do bugger all to fix the 21st century crises of healthcare, migration, globalization or social identity. Because any journalist worth their salt will tell you the biggest story is always the thing you're not being told. So what should be in those papers that isn't one? The files file FYI that's not this guy image Maria Emerald career criminal James Earl Files is the only person ever to confess to carrying out the assassination of JFK. He did so in 1994 shortly after starting a 50-year sentence for the attempted murder of two police officers, and claimed to have fired the fatal headshot at Kennedy from the notorious grassy knoll on behalf of mob bosses. He claimed that afterwards, he bit the bullet casing and left it behind as a calling card, before reversing his jacket and calmly walking away. Such a casing was later found, but the grassy knoll has spent bullet casings scattered around it on a fairly regular basis by people who find them and by pure coincidence have a new conspiracy theory to flog. Files might be telling the truth. He might be barking mad. The FBI said it had investigated and said publicly they found his claims not to be credible, but we don't know what they investigated, why he wasn't credible, or if his teeth marks matched the bullet casing. And his is still the sole confession it's worth noting, you'd have thought whether he's worth noting. But the files file does not appear to be in the latest data dump. If it's been marked top secret it could be locked away for decades, and seeing as only 1.4 million Americans have top secret clearance that'll never leak. Ahem, too. What TV script writers know, exactly in Red Dwarf Season 7, Dave Lister wants a tikka, so Betty and the rest of the crew travel back in time to his favorite curry house. They miscalculate and land in the Dallas Book Depository on November 22, 1963, inadvertently knock Lee Harvey Oswald out of the window and prevent the assassination. In the future that unfolds, JFK is impeached, the Soviets win the Cold War and the USA is a dystopia. Naturally, the boys persuade the future JFK to travel back in time with them, don a policeman's uniform, and stand on the grassy knoll to shoot the past JFK thereby restoring the timeline and his reputation. Lister does not get his curry. In the X-Files it turns out Fox Mulder's secret dad was ordered to shot JFK from a storm drain by a shadowy cabal of generals while the X-Men said it was metal magician Magneto. And it's in literature too. Marvel Comics had JFK killed by the son of Captain America, while a Doctor Who spin-off novel had him shot by a journalist trying to make up for the fact the master was messing around with history and had killed Oswald. With any other crime burglary, say if there was one group of people, all in the same job, saying it was down to time travel and or a spoon bender, you'd expect the FBI, at the very least, to bring the literati in for questioning. Is Uri Geller in those files? Is he hell? 3. What you're not looking at while you're looking at this, don't look at this conspiracy, try that other one over there image Reuters Russians hacked Donald Trump's main opponent and released documents to discredit her. Russians ran social media campaigns to spread fake news and get Trump elected. Trump's campaign manager is being investigated for allegedly taking Russian money and Trump's national security advisor was forced to resign over discussing Russian sanctions with the Russian ambassador, and is now being investigated for allegedly taking money from Russians. Meanwhile, Trump fired the man who started investigating his Russia links. His attorney general said he couldn't remember meeting the Russian ambassador. Trump's son admitted meeting a Russian lawyer about information that could help his dad win the election, and Facebook and Twitter have both decided to reveal or reject adverts or postings that come from Russian sources. It's believed Trump is now being investigated for obstruction of justice, is responsible for dictating his son's misleading statement about the Russian lawyer, and that his team are terrified the investigators have put moles wearing wires into the White House. It also turns out parts of a Trump dossier which included claims he demanded a golden shower from Russian prostitutes have now been proven true, although the urinary allegations remain unconfirmed. But don't look at that. Look at this 54-year-old story about a corseted sex pig president who was a little too friendly with the Russians instead. FR 4. Who killed Marilyn? Image Bettman. We now know that Marilyn had been boinked by three Kennedy brothers who'd passed her down like the family Bible. Not only JFK, Bobby and Teddy, but also Frank Sinatra and mob boss Sam Giancana's henchman Johnny Roselli, who has also been linked to James Files. We also know, conspiracy theories aside, that Marilyn was hooked on amphetamines, barbiturates and alcohol and spent some of her last hours alive with her on-call psychiatrist. Post-Weinstein, post-Pussygate, post-Savel, we now know what we didn't in 1962 when Marilyn died clutching her telephone receiver that you don't need to order a mob hit on a damaged woman to nevertheless be responsible for what happened to her. Men pursued her, and men killed her. 5. Exactly how the Cuba Missile Crisis was resolved would they tell us if the answer was a mutant mind reader? No, they would not. Image Rex. In 1962 the USA had missiles in Turkey pointed at Russia. Russia moved a load of missiles to Cuba. The USA blockaded Cuba, and Russia sent more missiles, and there we were at DEFCON 2, a moment away from nuclear war. Officially what happened was the KGB boss in Washington went for lunch with an ABC News reporter and asked him to ask the US if they'd remove their missiles if the Russians removed theirs. 5 hours later Russian President Khrushchev sent a telegram saying the same thing, and the tension eased. The problem is this: if you want to establish secret talks to de-escalate nuclear war, would you ask a journalist to be middleman? Not unless you wanted the world and his wife to know. And the only reason you'd want everyone to think this is how it ended would be because you don't want them to know how it really ended, which was down to some teenage mutants. We all know that. 6. Who actually killed JFK? Yeah, release those files. No, not those files. The other files. Image Getty Images. North America. In 1963 Donald Trump was 17 years old. He was in the New York Military Academy and had yet to begin his consistent efforts at dodging the draft for the Vietnam War on the basis of bad feet. His father Fred had been arrested following a Ku Klux Klan riot in Queens in 1927, with charges later dismissed, and the documents revealed last night there had been claims that Kennedy's vice-president Lyndon Baines Johnson was once a member of the KKK in Texas during the early days of his political career. The KKK was vehemently anti-Catholic, JFK was Catholic. He also spent government money on alleviating harm to Native Americans, pursued a civil rights agenda and lifted laws that discriminated against foreign-born migrants. It was almost certainly in the KKK's best interests for JFK to be replaced by LBJ. All they needed was someone who didn't like foreigners and had a gun. Who might fit the bill? 7. Who benefits from all these conspiracy theories? Oh yeah, all right. Image Barcroft Media. The release of these files, which was supposed to once and for all answer all the conspiracies, has merely reignited them. And for a single one of those conspiracies to be true or for the evidence to exist to prove it, someone needs to be stupid enough to have written down the minutes of a meeting involving the CIA, FBI, KGB, Dallas Police Department, Fidel Castro, the Warren Commission, Jack Ruby, Lee Harvey Oswald, and the New York Mafia's five families, in which the motion was discussed, moved and approved to kill JFK in the most insanely complicated manner possible. While our brains are stuck in this never-ending spaghetti junction of an Alice in Wonderland spin-off, the man who got to the White House by making everyone think everything was a conspiracy against them, and whose position is rather tenuous, is still there. The mundane truth is probably that Oswald got lucky, and the CIA covered up the fact they knew about him in advance and didn't take him seriously. Trust me, Trump is the only one who thinks the JFK papers are great news.